Hi, I'm Micah Garrett with BuildBlock Building Systems, and today we're going to show you how to mount electrical boxes. We're going to go over some of the tools and show you some of the tips and tricks to make this a fast and easy install. First, you're going to need some electrical boxes. You might want to use plastic boxes. One of the best styles to use is one with a flange on the side, or you might use metal boxes. These are a style that you can mount directly to the concrete. Both are fine and effective. It's just a matter of how you install them. Is what you want to be able to follow. Some of the tools to use to make this job go quickly and effectively are a hot knife. This allows you to cut the foam out really quickly, easily, and effectively. You may also just want to use a basic handsaw. This can do everything that a hot knife can do also, just takes a little bit more grunt work. You might also consider picking up an electric chainsaw. You can find these at your big box store, your Do It Best, your LBM, whatever it is. This is about a $50 purchase that will make your job go a lot faster. So right here, we're gonna be mounting a plastic box. I'm gonna wanna put this right next to where an actual web is. And so here, I've just kinda drawn out where this box is gonna go. I've measured this up. The base of this box is sitting at about between 12 and 13 inches, and then we'll cut up through this section right here. This, we drew this a little bit too high, so that's just a mistake. This is where we're gonna be cutting out the box. This is a fairly inexpensive tool. It allows us to make simple cuts on this wall itself. What I'm gonna make sure I do right here is I'm gonna cut right up next to this web so that the flange here will be able to mount right on that web. So this takes a second to heat up. You can see it starting to get warm here. This makes it real simple to just insert this knife in, and I can cut down right where I've already marked. And this is very fast and simple to cut these boxes out. And I just want to make sure I get around all the corners here. Sometimes it can stick a little bit. So now we've got this cut out. I can now take a simple lever here and pop this out. You'll also notice that occasionally here at the interconnect, there's a little bit of concrete that sticks out. I can take a simple tool like this and be able to chip this out with a hammer. And that'll allow me to mount the box a little bit more flush here in the back if I need to. So this box is now ready to be mounted. So in this case, we're going to mount a metal box, and I'm going to cut this out using a hot knife. See, that just goes right in there. Very easy to cut this out. Now, if you don't have a hot knife, you can also use a basic handsaw. This you can cut out just like you would anything else. Make sure you get all the way to the back of the wall there. And you can see it doesn't take too much time to cut one of these out. And I'm going to grab a lever here. Loosen this up. And that will pull right on out. And we're a touch tight, so we're just gonna take out a little bit of this foam here on top. So now that I have my box here, I'm going to be cutting a chase to this box on either side. So I want to knock out a couple of these little pieces to make sure I can run my wire straight into it. That'll make it a little easier for the electrician later. Set my box in place. And then what I'm gonna do using a drill and a masonry bit, I'm gonna be drilling a hole into the back. I wanna make sure that I'm nice and level here, got the box right where I want it. And now my box is nice and secure. So here I'm gonna be taking an electric chainsaw to cut my electrical chases from box to box. I'm gonna be cutting right here at the interconnect because this is a place where there is no webs. The chainsaw makes it quick and easy, allowing me to cut this and go all the way across from box to box. So now we have our chase that is cut from electrical box to electrical box. This is the place where I can now insert my electrical wire, and this conforms to the depth requirement required by most building codes. So I can take my wire and insert it directly back here, put it back behind here, and then to secure it in place, I can put a little drop of foam every now and then to make sure that that wire isn't going to come out of place. And you can see this connects all the way across from box to box and ties into the wall here where the wire can now come down and connect.